powerful weapon which you can use to change the world by Nelson Mandela. It is my great pleasure to welcome you all to the second online mega international conference on continuity, consistency and innovation in applied sciences and humanities here in SNH department, St. Martin's Engineering College. We are very grateful to the part of St. Martin's for the tremendous support they have provided as host. Good morning, everyone. This is Dr. Himambika. Delighted to welcome our chairman, Sri Marilakshman Reddy Garu, Executive Director, Sri G. Chandrasekhar Yadav Garu, our dynamic principal and president of this program, Dr. P. Santosh Kumar Patra sir. And I welcome eminent speaker and chief guest of today's program, Dr. C. D. Sebastian, Professor, Department of Humanities and Social Sciences, Indian Institute of Technology, Bombay, from Mumbai. And convener of this program, Dr. Randhir Reddy sir, Professor and Head of the Department, Science and Humanities. College directors, HODs, Dean Academics, faculty, and it is my pleasure to welcome all the participants for second online mega international conference conducting 29th, 30th July 2021, organized by SNH Department of St. Martin's Engineering College. Our college is a prestigious UGC Autonomous Engineering College and first choice by aspiring students and parents. SMEC is adjusted with esteemed NAC A+ grade from UGC Paramarsh Mentor. SMEC also have achieved the prestigious NIRF ranking, ranked second by Wikipedia, ranked third by Competition Success Review, national ranked by ARIIA, NBA accredited, ISO certified, ATAL ranking, DSIR remote recognition, remote center of IIT Mumbai, member of CII and MSME certifications, 8,800 research papers and 161 patents. Institution has signed more than 88 MOUs with the world's topest major companies and foreign universities. The college is a recipient of Glorious Governor Award thrice. It is being declared as Best Sports College by Stumach Telangana. National Leadership Excellence Award 2019 by ICCI. Our college has now become one of the great institutions of the city, and to achieve greatness, it has all the important prerequisites such as an expansive campus, conducive environmental and all-round growth, experienced faculty, dedicated students, necessary financial resources, etc. Now, I cordially invite convener of second online mega international conference, Dr. Randhir Reddy sir, Professor, Head of the Department, Science and Humanities, will introduce today's program. Over to you, sir.
Yeah, good morning, everyone. I'm Dr. Randhir Reddy, Head of the Department of Science and Humanities, St. Martin's Engineering College, and convener of this second online mega international conference on continuity, consistency, and innovation in applied sciences and humanities 2021. Firstly, I heartily welcome our chairman, sir, Sri Marilakshman Reddy Garu, executive director, Sri Chandrasekhar Yadav Garu, respected principal, sir, Dr. P. Santosh Kumar Patra, sir, and the chief guest of today's event, Dr. C. D. Sebastian, sir, professor, Department of Humanities and Social Sciences, IIT Bombay, and the Dean and Head of the Departments of different department, colleagues and the participants. At first, I congratulate and appreciate all the registered participants in this multidisciplinary international conference. It is our proud privilege to encourage and support all the research scholars, aspirants and students to upgrade your awareness and zeal to find innovative concepts on your respective research areas by using this online platform. I assure you that this new virtual mode of learning through sharing and communication will strengthen your research contribution process. In this global village, anyone can learn from anybody else without any physical strain or mental strain. Our conference is successfully connecting you people all together in a single roof to spread the knowledge to all over the world. During this two-day online conference, nearly 270 plus candidates are invited to present the research articles. I hope every participant can utilize the opportunity in an allotted time slot. And I congratulate to all the participants and convey my best wishes for your enlightened talks. And I end my talk by saying the best research you can do is it to think and talk, listen and realize. And thank you very much for giving this opportunity. Thank you. Over to you, Emma.
Thank you, sir, for your best introduction of today's program. Leaders will be those who empower others. I take the privilege of inviting someone whose ideas have molded us. He is none other than our principal, Dr. P. Santosh Kumar Patra, sir, a recognized academician and educational administrator with the objective of producing the highest echelon of technocrats. Sir, with 18 years of experience and his desire to work smart and endeavor for excellence and to empower others to enjoy the journey every step of the way made him scale greater heights. Under his excellency as a principal, innovative thinking, able leadership, meticulous planning, dynamism, dedication, diligence, and commitment have achieved great laurels for SMEC. He is holding BE, MTech, and PhD in Computer Science and Engineering. He has been honored with Governor Award thrice, Rashtriya Gaurav Award, Rashtriya Vikas Radhan Award, and Dronacharya Award, and Young Leader of the Year 2019 and IBAE International Award from Dubai. He has achieved 86 lakhs from DST, IIT Mumbai, and AICTE. He is maintaining the highest consultancy and industry-sponsored projects in Telangana, about 594 crores from GHMC Hyderabad. He also an UGC Paramarsh advisor. He has facilitated 300 Akash tablets from IIT Mumbai. In his crowning glory, he has achievements like 18 books, 30 patents, 108 research papers, 16 magazine articles, and 138 newspaper coverage. He is on the editorial board of Tata McGraw-Hill International Publication. He is an active member of various technical educations from various countries like Canada, USA, Singapore, and technical advisor for Alexa Japa. Being a part of St. Martin's, we are very fortunate to have such a walking visionary to guide us in the right direction for achieving success in our attempts. Now, I would like to invite our principal, sir, and navigator of this flagship of knowledge to present the preamble of this program. Over to you, sir.
So thank you, Hemambika madam, for a brief introduction. So first of all, respected chairman, Sri M. Lakshman Reddy sir, respected executive director, Sri G. Chandrasekhar Yadav sir, and the convener of this program, Dr. D. Randir Reddy, and who is the HOD of S&H department, and chief guest of today's program, Dr. C.D. Sebastian, who is a professor of Department of Humanities and Social Science from IIT Bombay, and other all invited guests, HODs and deans, and the staff member of S&H department, coordinator, National Advisory Board, International Advisory Board, participant and students, and all the people who are all attending today, the participant across the globe, a very good morning to all of you. I am Dr. Santosh Kumar Patra, principal of St. Martin Engineering College. Wholeheartedly, I would like to welcome you all to this second online mega international conference, which is titled as Continuity, Consistency, and Innovation in Applied Sciences and Humanities. Today we are celebrating the inauguration, and followed with you will have parallel sessions, and also tomorrow also lot of sessions are also parallel sessions have been planned. At the outset, I would like to first congratulate and appreciate Dr. Randir Reddy and his entire dynamic team, because I am noticing From March 2020, almost 1 year, 4 months have completed. We are working with on and offline mode, and majority it is all online mode. And this is the 7th event, which is all organized by S&H department. And past 6 events I have witnessed, it was a mega success. And I wish the 7th event also should be a mega success, and it should add glory to the Department of Science and Humanities. Kudos to the entire team, and appreciation to the HOD and the team, how dedicatedly they worked, and they have brought it, this idea, into reality. I would like to mention one more point here. In my tenure as a principal, I have never seen any international conference, especially which are all organized by Science and Humanities Department, could able to attract this many papers. So I really appreciate the entire team, how they have disseminated this information to the all the stakeholders and all the participants, and could able to attract lot of papers. And I am surprised to note that 270 papers are scheduled for the presentation for today and tomorrow. Really, heads up to you, and really, I wholeheartedly, again, I would like to appreciate.
Sir, you are muted.
So this shows, this 270 papers which are all have been selected, this shows the dedication and the hard work by the Department of S&H department and the staff member who has worked for this program day and night. So as the title is quite interesting, so I thought, okay, let me have a small discussion on this title. As the title says about the continuity, consistency and innovation in applied sciences and humanities. See, so all the day we were discussing about innovations and advancement, technological refinement in different engineering subjects. But it is quite interesting to have a debate and discussion on the innovation, which are all related to science and humanities. And basically, I strongly believe the real innovations comes from the S&H department. And that leads to the that leads to a innovation base for the all the engineering branches. So the real innovation should come from the physics, chemistry and mathematics, all these basic science courses which are all available. So and I could recall one small incident, and I wanted to put it here in this forum for a discussion, because lot of papers have come on different domains, and good researchers have contributed their lot of significant work to bring out and to develop lot of good papers and all that will be in the discussion. But I could able to recall one of the incident, and where this small research has changed the entire phenomenon of this mechanical engineering and its product. See, we all are familiar. So whenever we use a vehicle, it could be a two-wheeler or it could be a four-wheeler or what kind of vehicle it is. So everybody is familiar that there is a product which is all required by any of the engine, that is named as the engine oil. And if you look into the composition of engine oil mainly consists of hydrocarbons. It could be oxygenated or it is non-oxygenated. And in addition to that, it also consists of a little amount of sulfur as well as nitrogen, which always added, and some additives also is included into it, so that it will to improve its performance. So this is the way all the engine oils were made and it was used. So down the line, it is noticed this engine oils, if we will start pouring into the engines and all, wherever the climatic conditions of the weather is changed and it go to all extreme, then these engine oils are not supporting and they are all creating problems. For an example, let's say we have gone to a place where the temperature is -5 or -10 degrees Celsius. Then this traditional engine oils, what happens? It become freezes and it become ice. And when it will be melted, then the water component, it goes into the engine and it sees the engine. Then the chemist, the people, those who are very good in chemistry, what they have done, a small modification. And what they did, anyway, the major component is the hydrocarbons. So they changed the chemical structure of these hydrocarbons, and they added some mineral water at the molecular level, and they brought out another modified engine, and that engine oil that is named as the fully synthetic engine oil. And with this fully synthetic engine oil, it is quite interesting. Those extreme climatic change conditions have been controlled fully. And nowadays, it is all widely used. So, see, the real innovation has happened in the S&H department by one chemistry, you know, experts by doing a molecular changes in the component. So, similarly, lot of innovations we could able to see in the area of physics, in the area of organic or non-organic chemistry, or in the area of mathematics by changing lot of formulas and all. So, really, I appreciate the department for coining such a beautiful title and attracting lot of papers. I really am confident that now all the participants are going to get benefit out of this entire exercise. And I would like to appreciate and congratulate all the participants for three level of achievement. One is what? Through a strong scrutiny process, your paper is selected for the presentation today, and tomorrow you will be getting an opportunity to present your work in front of the best experts. And your paper, as it is all accepted, it will be proceeding in an international conference proceeding with an ISBN number. And the third and attractive benefit is what? All of the selected paper will go for an international journal publishing with free of cost. So kudos to all the participants for getting these three level of achievements. And so hopefully these 2 days you will utilize to learn your knowledge and enhance your skill set to do further for the benefit of the society. Again, at the outset, I would like to convey my gratitude, and also I would like to say thanks to our chief guest of today's program, Dr. C.D. Sebastian, sir, because already I had my past experience with IIT Bombay, and I know how IIT Bombay works and how the IIT Bombay professors works. It is something like 24/7. There is no rest hour at all, and research scholar will be coming and works will be going on, and I know how sir will be also busy. And thank you very much, sir, with our short notice and with a simple invitation, you are kind enough to give respect our invitation, and you have given your kind consent to be with us as a chief guest, and also you have agreed to address the keynote speaker also. So I appreciate and I convey my gratitude on behalf of me and the entire staff member and the management of St. Martin Engineering College. So finally, I wish all the very best to the organizer and to all the participants. Have a great learning, and thanks for listening to me. Do take care of yourself. Now I am signing out. Thank you very much for the opportunity. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
We are indebted for your great words. You have been a constant motivator and mesmerizes the audience with the style and substance. Thank you very much, sir, for your appreciations to the team S&H. What are you expecting and encouraging the innovations in the basic sciences in science and humanities department? Sure, we will do our best with your support and guidance, sir. Thank you very much, sir. This is the time for proceedings release by our dynamic principal and president of this program, Dr. P. Santosh Kumar Patra, sir.
So I declare the conference is open, and this is the cover page of the proceeding where all the participants, you can see that ISBN number what we have obtained, and the entire conference proceeding also will be kept available in the website, and as well as it will be communicated to all of you and soon after the inauguration session. So thank you, and over to the Dr. Hemambika to proceed with the next agenda.
Now I invite Mani to introduce our beloved speaker.
Good morning, everyone. I'm Amani D, working as an assistant professor in the Department of Humanities and Sciences, St. Martin's Engineering College. Take the privilege to introduce the chief guest of this international conference, Dr. C.D. Sebastian, Professor, Department of Humanities and Social Sciences, Indian Institute of Technology. Dr. C.D. Sebastian pursued his postdoctoral research at University of Bristol, UK, and PhD from Banaras Hindu University, Varanasi, Master of Arts with 2 gold medals from Banaras Hindu University, Bachelor of Theology with the highest distinction from Rome, Italy, and Bachelor of Arts from Vikram University, Ujjain, India. He has been working in IIT Bombay since 2004. Search research interests are Indian philosophy, comparative philosophy, emotional empathy and moral cognition, and his research areas are Buddhist philosophy, Sankhya philosophy, Vedant philosophy and philosophy of religion. He taught courses more than 15 like Vedant philosophy in Vedic tradition, Buddhist Mahayana philosophy, reasoning in Indian philosophy, etc. He published 5 monographs, 120 publications in national and international reputed journals, and he received awards and recognitions like Banaras Hindu University Gold Medal and Pandit Raghunandan Lal Dar Gold Medal and Srimati Rajkumari Dar Prize for standing first at MA Philosophy and Indian Philosophy and Religion Examination at Banaras Hindu University, Varanasi. Sir got Banaras Hindu University Fellowship and a recipient of present from the Jawaharlal Nehru Memorial Fund, and also he is a member of Society for Asian and Comparative Philosophy, Intercultural Philosophy, and Sir is also an editor of Journal and Sacred Scripture. And he is also known for his excellence in teaching IIT Bombay. Under Sir's guidance, 11 PhD scholars and 3 MPhil scholars pursued successfully. We are very fortunate to have such a renowned person as a chief guest of our conference. Sir delivers his lecture on whole brain empowering and role on humanities in innovation. Now I request Dr. C.D. Sebastian, Professor, Department of Humanities and Social Sciences, Indian Institute of Technology, Bombay, to address the participants.
Thank you so much for the kind word of introduction. Kemampika, you could mute all if someone is speaking in between. Okay, then tell me to unmute myself. Right? Okay? Am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Yes. Okay. So thank you. Dr. P. Santosh Kumar Patra, the president of the inaugural session of the conference and the principal of St. Martin's Engineering College, Hyderabad. And Dr. Sri M. Lakshman Reddy, chairman of the college. Dr. G. Durgaya Yadav, vice chairman. Dr. Sri G. Chandrasekhar Yadav, executive director. And Dr. Randhir Reddy, professor and head department of science and humanities. Dr. Sunil, it was he who first got in touch with me to invite me to this international conference and took care of logistics. And the dear colleagues of the college, participants, students, and all other functionaries of the college. Thank you very much for the kind introduction. I thank you also, what I can say, very much for inviting me all to be here today as the chief guest and keynote speaker of the inaugural of this international conference on continuity, consistency, and innovation. Lovely terms. Continuity, consistency, and innovation in applied sciences and humanities. I appreciate and congratulate, as the principal said at the outset, I appreciate and congratulate the principal first, then the head and the convener of the program, faculty members of Department of Humanities, Science and Humanities, and all other faculty colleagues of the college for organizing such a wonderful conference on such a relevant theme and topic. I shall be very brief. Am I okay, Kemampika? Are you there? I am okay? Audible?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Audible.
Okay. You know, I am a teacher, so there is no PowerPoint. So I will speak. I hope it is okay with you. Okay? So I shall be brief in my talk. The whole brain empowering role of humanities in innovation. That's what I had proposed. The theme of the conference is the innovation in applied sciences and humanities. But I'm not limiting myself to sciences and humanities alone. I'm looking at innovation in all fields, and the role of humanities in innovation is recognized in the world all over today. Let me begin with that the other day. You know, I was very happy to listen to Principal Dr. Santosh Patra, Umash Patra, telling that your college is the best sports college of Telangana. So congratulations. You know, it's not only engineering and technology we teach, you give them an all-round development. So this is something fabulous. And let me begin with the other day's good news in Tokyo Olympics, that an EPFL postdoctoral fellow in mathematics in the Faculty of Basic Sciences, Anna Hisham Hofer, winning the gold medal for a 40-kilometer road race in cycling, stunning all superstars in cycling. I hope my student friends know what is EPFL. Please, you know, this is also, I'm a teacher, you know, it's all good for you to know what is EPFL. EPFL, you know, Ecole Polytechnique Federale de Lausanne. Means it is an equivalent of MIT in Switzerland. And the equivalent of MIT in IIT, I would say it is the IITs. So it's just the most prestigious place. And a postdoctoral fellow from there goes in mathematics, goes and gets the gold medal in cycling. And you know, this is an example of the whole brain empowering. I do not know how many of us know that Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam learned playing veena when he was with the DRDO from 1985 to 1996. And he played veena all throughout his life. This is also an example of whole brain empowering. And my theme is that one. Before coming to the humanities as such, whole brain empowering, let me just have, you know about it. Let me just have a brief an introduction analysis of the human brain, how people, human brain is considered, conceived, understood today. The human brain is an intricate organ, and we know that one. At approximately 1.36 or 37, whatever you want to say, 36 kilograms, it contains about 100 billion neurons and 100 trillion connections. Mind you, 100 billion neurons and 100 trillion connections in my brain. Your brain is command central of all you think, all you feel, all you do. Your brain is divided into two halves. That's what the traditional understanding, two hemispheres. You know, within each half, a particular region controls certain functions. There's two sides of your brain, two sides of our brain look very much alike, but there is a huge difference in how they process information. Despite their contrasting styles, the two halves of your brain don't work independently to each other. This I say, they don't work independently of each other. So my friends, innovators, paper presenters in this seminar, please remember that technology engineering is not enough. Alone is not enough. So our brain and both halves do not work independently of each other. This is my point as a student of philosophy to make before you. Different parts of your brain are connected by nerve fibers. If a brain injury is severe, the connection between these sides, you could still function. But the lack of integration would cause some impairment, some malfunction. Let me come to the theory of these two halves before I go to the next section. The theory is that people are left-brained or right-brained, meaning that one side of their brain is dominant. If you are mostly analytical, methodical, mathematical in your thinking, you are said to be left-brained. Can you mute everyone? I will unmute myself. Yeah?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Okay. Am I okay? Am I audible?
Yes, sir, you are audible.
Okay, okay. I'm not too boring, right?
No, sir, not at all, sir.
Okay, okay, let us continue. What I was saying, the theory is that people are either left-brained or right-brained, meaning that one side of our brain is dominant. If you are mostly mathematical, analytical, methodological in thinking, you are said to be left-brained. That's what people say. I'm not sure. I want to make another point with this. If you tend to have more creative, artistic, aesthetics, other innovative, intuitive aspect, they say that you are right-brained. So right brain and left brain. And do you know who spoke about it? That's for my students, it is very interesting that they should know at least one name from my talk. The theory is based on the fact that the brain's hemispheres function differently. This first came to light in 1960s, thanks to the research of psychobiologist, neurobiologist, Nobel Prize winner, Roger Sperry. I do not know whether my friends, students know about him. Just one word about him. It's very interesting. Roger Sperry won Nobel Prize in 1981. What for what? For his work in the split two hemispheres of brain. And he said that, you know, brain can be compartmentalized into two. And he got his Nobel Prize in physiology and medicine. And you know, there is a journal called the Review of General Psychology. This is one of the leading journals in psychology. And their survey says that he is one of the topmost psychologists who is referred to and cited in 20th century. So, The brain, split brain, two hemisphere theory is not shunted. That's what I wanted to say. And you know, according to this theory, the left brain is more verbal, more analytical, more orderly, and right brain than the right brain. Okay, it is sometimes called the digital brain. And I would say that majority of my friends, my principal, or those who are sitting there, they all are of this kind. Not necessarily that they are controlled by the left brain, but more of them. Because my friends in engineering departments, in mathematics, in computer science, they all of them have a set pattern of rigorous analytic mind. It is sometimes for digital brain. It's better at things like they are better at planning, executing, reading, writing, comprehending, and computations and calculations. They will be very good at it. The right brain people, on the other hand, is more artistic, imaginative, visual, creative, intuitive, and at the end of the day, they are innovative. Thinking out of the box comes from this facet of the brain, the right brain. That doesn't mean that, you know, Dr. Patra, who is sitting in front of me, is fully left-brained or fully right-brained. We are a mixture of both. Okay. However, you know, friends, there is something different now. You know, why I am saying so, he was with the Professor Deepak Patak, one of our Padma Shri professors in computer science. And he started this small talk about the school children, the Akash project. And it was a big news. And Dr. Patra worked with that project when Professor Patak was a Patak retired now, but he is still here. And you know, that project. So that innovation, Dr. Patra, that comes from your right brain, not from your left brain. You imagined, you thought it is needed for our children, the emotional wavelength with connected with the people of the land who is not privileged as others are coming to IIT, and this was the innovation. So the feeling with the other side, with your left brain, you thought with your right brain, and you connected. And this is very essential for a country like ours, not only country like ours, every country. So we need a comprehensive growth of our brain. This is what I am saying. Okay. Now, however, you know what happened? These two hemispheres, new split part of the brain theory is challenged today. In 2013, there was another study by the neurologists and the people, those who are working on, they studied 2 years. The recent study on brain are not in favor of this two hemispheres brain theory. This is what I would like to tell you. And you know, there is a journal called PLOS. I do not know whether my students know it. There is a journal called PLOS. PLOS is a journal, you know, please know, students, PLOS, this is very important for you. PLOS is a journal, and this journal is what you can say, it's got a short full form, Public Library of Science. Public Library of Science. It was still 2020 was known as that way, but today people just call it PLOS only. And the most authentic research papers in science, engineering, and technology, medicine, everything comes in PLOS without paying, which is I want to open it for all public domain. So it is, it comes in PLOS. And in 2013, on the August 14th, academicians like Jared Nielsen and four others, they brought out a paper after 2 years of rigorous study in brain, an evaluation of left brain against right brain hypothesis with the resting state function of cognitivity, magnet reasoning, imaging. And you know what they said? They said this theory of two hemispheres acting separately is a nonsense. Brains are not acting separately. That was their study. And you know what they said? Something more about it. They found no proof that this theory is correct. Magnetic resonance imaging of 1,000 people they mapped, and that revealed that human brain doesn't actually favor one side or the other. So Dr. Randhir Reddy or Dr. Patha, I cannot say that in a, since he is coming from science and humanities, he's a right brain person. Since Dr. Patha is coming from engineering and computer science, I cannot say that he is left brain person. And that theory is abolished. They say that, you know, the network on one side aren't generally stronger than the network on the other side. These two hemispheres, two areas, two parts are tied together by bundles of nerve fibers, creating an information highway. Although the two sides function differently, they work together and complement each other. You don't use only one side, but you use your whole brain. And this is what my talk is all about. We use our whole brain to innovate. You need your left brain to analyze things, and you need your right brain to give imagination, creative thinking, feel with the people, and you know, what, invent or innovate something which is needed for my society, my people, my community, my country. And this is what. So the whole brain training is needed today. Whether you are performing logical or creative function, you're receiving input from both sides of your brain. For example, the left brain is credited with the language, but the right brain helps you to understand the context and the tone. It analyzes, but if somebody is angry, somebody is not angry, this is your right brain which will tell you. The emotional mapping takes place by the right brain. So the left brain handles mathematical equations, but the right brain helps out to comparison and you know, estimate things and understand and fathom the things. This is the brain study. General personality traits, individual preferences, learning style don't translate into notion that you are left-brained or right-brained. Still, I would like to say that it's a fact that two sides of your brain are different. Please remember that one. And certain areas of your brain do have specialities. The exact area of some functions can vary a bit from each person. So my thesis is this, end of the day, how many minutes I have taken, I will take another 2-4 minutes more. Hema Biga?
Yes, sir, sure, sir.
Yeah, please, I have not completed. Okay, it does not say that there are no two sides in brain. Okay, there are, they have functions, but it says that these two sides act in support of each other. They are complementary. So my thesis is this, we need to strengthen both the sides of your brain, hemispheres of your brain for innovation. And for that, humanities, the role of humanities is much more than all other branches. Humanities play a determined role in producing not only right kind of a doctor, mechanical engineer, computer scientist, or entrepreneur or a designer that make the world so protective. The reason I suggest is that humanities provide students with the best opportunities for learning how to innovate. I do not know where you have heard of a study which came of in the media, in the international discussions for last 10 years, and that was published. That study is published by Harvard University Press, and it came out some 10 years ago. There is a study of Claudia Goldwyn and Lawrence Katz, which came out as a book. The race, the title of the book is The Race Between Education and Technology. And you know what this book shows? It shows that in the face of limited resources, the face of limited resources in India and elsewhere in America, administrators and politicians and policymakers are urged to invest more in science, engineering, and technology programs. Because they, the DST, DRDO, the big chunk of our investment for research, it goes to the science and engineering. Meanwhile, liberal arts colleges are becoming an engendered species. And you know, this was a problem. And there is a professor called in Northwestern University, his name is Mark Mills. And Mark Mills, you know, he has got a beautiful book of 2020, The Digital Cathedrals. And he, and there is another professor from the same university, Giulio Ottino, and they spoke about whole brain engineering, whole brain training philosophy. And I owe much to them, their philosophical concept. And you know, the whole brain engineering philosophy, and that fetched him in 2017, the Bernard Gordon Prize for Innovation in Engineering and Technical Education from the National Academy of Engineering. So what they said, they published a paper in Forbes. Forbes is a magazine that is also for my students, F-O-R-B-E-S, Forbes is a magazine. It is 100 plus years old magazine. And you know, you get solid information from this magazine. We need more resonance scientists. And you know what they said there? They said that we need to empower our students to become whole brain engineers, whole brain scientists, whole brain entrepreneurs. This means integrating elements of left brain thinking, that is analysis, logic, synthesis, and mathematics, with the right brain thinking, fosters intuition, metaphorical thought, thinking out of the box, creative problem solving, and to lead effectively, one has to be a master of both. And I conclude with an explanation. You know, in IIT Bombay, restructuring our BTech program. IIT Bombay, we are remodeling our undergraduate program. When I joined in 2004, it was 13% of entire curriculum for a BTech student was from the humanities and social sciences. Now it has gone down to 6%. Now we are planning, Professor Chatterjee committee is already came to Senate also, it's all saying that we should have at least 25 to 30% of under BTech training in humanities and social sciences. This has something to do, you know, we all follow the MIT pattern. And you know what happened with MIT? MIT has already introduced, they have something called HASS, HASS means humanities, arts and social sciences. And you know, every student, yeah, means, you know, the big chunk, I think it's 35% of the undergraduate students in MIT have to take this humanities, arts, social sciences paradigm module, at least out of some 35, I think 8 or 9 courses they have to do it. And it means every semester, if suppose if the physics, there are 2 terms of physics in MIT for an undergrad, 2 terms of calculus and 1 term of chemistry, and 1 term of biology. This is all compulsory, you know, biology also compulsory. So, and with that one, 8 terms, humanities and social sciences. So this is the way things are happening in the world. So Martin's Engineering College also should think and strengthen the humanities for the innovation. And you know, humanities will open up a wide range of things. To sum up, it's not that humanities disciplines are more innovative than other scientific counterparts engineering on the way. It's simply that students are required to practice innovative thinking earlier on their studies. Mind you, this happens at the BTEC level when students are above 17, the teens, when they are in the early 20s, if they are given this innovative, imaginative training, creative thinking, and they know they will invent, they will innovate much more when they go ahead. Always remember, thought leaders, innovation, everything comes from humanities. That's it. Thank you so much.
Thank you for your valuable insights. That was wonderful listening to you, sir. We are blessed with your intellects and innovative ideas. Now, I would like to hand over the session to Dr. Himambika, ma'am.
Thank you, Amani. This is the time for a vote of thanks. On behalf of St. Martin's Engineering College and entire management group here, I'm very heartful gratitude to our chairman, sir, Sri Marilakshman Reddy Garu, Executive Director, Sri G. Chandrasekhar Yadav Garu, for their great support. And we are very much thankful to the president of today's event, that is our dynamic principal, Dr. P. Santosh Kumar Patra, sir, for his immense guidance to reach this program great success. I give a really heartfelt vote of thanks to our chief guest, Dr. C. D. Sebastian, Professor, Department of Humanities and Social Sciences, Indian Institute of Technology, Mumbai, who spent his busiest time gracing the occasion by delivering the beautiful information that the importance of human brain is nothing but a digital brain and hemisphere brain theory and hypothesis of
conceptions against human brain.
This type of incident cannot happen over a night. The wheels start moving about 2 months ago. It requires planning and bird's eye for details. We have been fortunate to the supporters by our convener of this program, Dr. Ranadhir Reddy, sir, professor and head of the Department Science and Humanities. Thank you very much, sir. Heartfelt thanks to college directors, HODs, Dean Academics. I would like to thank all our faculty and SNH department worked hard and gave immense support those behind this program. Thank you very much, all the distinguished participants. Because of your wonderful responses, this program is achieved a success ratio. Thank you one and all. Say safe. Safe. All the participants, get ready for the paper presentations. The program link.